submitting myself to the Supreme Personality, Bhagwan Shri Swaminarayan. Jai Swaminarayan. Dear students, once during the worst famine in the Saurashtra region of Gujarat that had ever been faced in its history, the condition was so bad that no one would get even a job of labor. People living in the region used to hardly get a single time meal. The land was completely dry. No water in the region. Everyone were just hoping and praying God to see better days come into their life. In such a famine region, there also lived a stanch devotee of Bhagwan Swaminarayan, namely Ghela Kohli from Loya, who used to regularly perform puja, follow Panchavartaman and all the spiritual names very strongly. Few days later, Ghela Kohli and his wife decided to go to Surat in search of a job so that they could earn some amount of money and survive in this famine. Dear students, those were not the days like today where people had car bikes with them. They had only bullock carts and horses with them for traveling. Whereas Ghela Kohli, being financially poor, he had nothing along with him. Thus, he and his wife started their journey towards Surat by walk. They carried puja kit, pair of clothes, some amount of food and money with them. Days passed. Now this journey became horrible. Yet both of them were chanting Swaminarayan Mahamantra and remembering Bhagwan Swaminarayan all the way. Ghela Kohli was far ahead from his wife as she was lagging back just due to tiredness. Suddenly, Ghela Kohli's leg was hit by a hard substance. Out of pain, Ghela Kohli bent down. He further wished to see what the hard substance was. To his surprise, that was a glittering golden bracelet. Seeing such a bracelet fallen on a path like this, Ghela Kohli thought, who might be the owner of this? He stood up, looked all around, but found no one except his wife, who was also far behind from him. A thought clicked in Ghela Kohli's mind that this is a test taken from a beloved God. At that moment, he remembered the command of Bhagwan Swaminarayan written in Shikshapatri, slok number 17, which states that Stena karma na kartavyam dharmartham api kenachit sa swami kasta pushpadi na grayam tadnagnaya. The meaning of this shloka is, my followers shall never commit any kind of theft even for the sake of religious purpose. An object such as firewood, flowers shall never be taken without the owner's permission. He also thought that, how can I disobey the command and the promise that I made to my guru just for my bodily comfort? Dear students, don't you think that this was a mind-tempting test taken from a god? Just imagine you are passing by a path or riding on a bike and you come across someone's wallet, mobile phone or something which is costly fallen on a path like this. What would you do? How would you respond to such a situation? The answer might be different for all of us. But let's see how a stanch devotee Ghela Kohli responded to such kind of situation. Dear students, the way Ghela Kohli responded to the situation was unimaginable. He looked all around but found no one except his wife as the place was solitary. Using this golden bracelet, it would be possible to see happiness into this mind. Although facing tough times, being financially poor, Ghela Kohli did not take the golden bracelet as he was aware of Panchavartaman and the command of Bhagwan Swaminarayan that not to take anything which does not belong to oneself. He was not at all attracted to the golden bracelet. Knowing that his wife was far behind from him, Ghela Kohli took the sand, poured it onto the golden bracelet and covered the bracelet with it, thinking that if my wife spots this golden bracelet, she may get attracted to it. Ghela Kohli then stood up and further continued his journey towards Surat. Dear students, remember, real faith rolls out only in difficult times. After passing a long path, Ghela Kohli and his wife sat under a tree out of tiredness, where his wife asked him a question. Tell me what you were doing long back, sitting down on the path. Gheera Kohli thought that there is nothing wrong in speaking the truth. With boldness, he replied that I poured the sand onto the golden bracelet and covered the bracelet with it, so that if you spot this golden bracelet, you would get attracted to it and use it to see happy days into this mind. Dear students, the understanding of Gheera Kohli's wife was even better than him. She asked him, "What have you done? You have poured dust onto other dust?" After realizing Bhagwan Swaminarayan, others' wealth is just like dust for me. After listening such a response from his wife, Gheera Kohli was spellbound. Thereafter, Gheera Kohli and his wife continued their journey and reached Surat. Finally, by the grace of Bhagwan Swaminarayan, both of them got their livelihood in Surat. Dear students, such understanding was there even in the illiterate women disciples of Bhagwan Swaminarayan, where this charitra shows us that how deeply the integrity and dharma was instilled even in the heart of such illiterate women. Now you may have a question that what one must do to develop the highest level of integrity and honesty towards dharma even in the difficult times. But before that, let me ask you a question. Frankly, tell me, can you perform well into your exams, into a sports event, or any other test of your life without making any advance preparation? The answer will be obviously no. Similarly, if you want to perform well into difficult times, we all must get prepared well in advance. So what we need to prepare today is still a question. Dear friends, the preparation we need to make today is, take a strong resolution that in future, I will never compromise with Panchavartaman and the command of Shikshapatri even in the difficult times. So let's all of us make a strong resolution like Gheera Kohli and become a staunch devotee by which Bhagwan Swaminarayan and all the saints are pleased on us. Thank you. Jai Swaminarayan.